Now let us discuss single versus multiple reference frame modeling. First we see why the rotating reference frame is necessary, why it is necessary to use in the ANSYS fluid. The first part is the flow field, which is unsteady when viewed in the stationary frame, and which this fluid flow is become steady when we view in the rotating frame. So the when we in the rotating frame, the flow field is steady, and steady state problem are easier to solve than unsteady problem. So that's why we use the rotating frame reference in the ANSYS. Here are some limitations of this rotating frame reference. We still have in the unsteadiness in the rotating frame due to turbulence of in the flow field and circumferential non-uniform variation in the flow and separation. For example, vertex shading from fan blade trailing edge. In that unsteadiness is occurred in that. That's why we not get a accurate simulation. First one is single reference frame, which is also known as SRF. Here in the entire computational domain is referred to moving reference frame, as shown in this figure. Stationary wall and blades are rotating. So in that SRF, that is single rotating frame reference, is sufficient for to specify the fluid domain and the fluid field. And this is multiple reference frame. In that selected regions of the domain are referred to moving reference frame. Interaction effect is ignored in this MRF. Here and as shown in this figure, in the stationary wall, buckles are attached, which are stationary. So we have to select one specified region with that blades are rotating. So here MRF, a multiple reference frame is necessary. Similarly, in this second also, blades are rotating at two axes of rotation. So here also MRF is necessary to specify the flow field. Okay, thank you for watching this video.